This one's a little different. An international mystery involving scandal, a secret video, and a sting operation. So big that it ousted two leading politicians and overturned a government. The scandalous recording, known as the Honey Trap video, was taken in a luxury villa in Ibiza in the summer of 2017. The guests, Austrian politicians Heinz Christian Strache and parliamentary group leader Johann Grudenis, the Honey, Alana Markarova, the so-called niece of a wealthy Russian oligarch. Not only was she a beautiful trap, but she proposed support for the far-right Freedom Party in exchange for under-the-table deals. The problem: the wealthy Russian oligarch does not have a niece. With hidden microphones and cameras installed into the villa's mobile phone charging station and light switches, the dealings were caught on film and published in two German newspapers. Over the course of 7 hours, the leaders became more and more entrenched in the trap. And the mystery remains: who was behind the entire operation? Neither of the newspapers that published the footage have revealed their source. Whoever the operative, their trap seems to have served its purpose. Strache was forced to resign as vice chancellor. Even today, the motive and identities of those who orchestrated the sting are unknown. Here's a video that is either 100% fake or 100% terrifying. A family from the Philippines is going for a joyride when they spot a pedestrian ahead of them who is scary enough to make them bust out the cameras and start recording. The obvious answer is that this person could have just pulled their shirt over their head as a prank, but look a little closer and you can see that there is a pair of fully developed shoulders that lead up to the neckline, right where the head should be. You can even see sweat stains where the shoulder blades are. Also, more importantly, how would they be able to walk so smoothly like that, with a shirt covering both of their eyes? This person definitely has a strong sense of direction. I can't tell if this video is real or not, but a local myth in the Philippines would suggest it is actually real. Apparently, when you live in the Philippines and you see a person who is missing their head, it is a symbol that means they are going to pass away soon. Therefore, a lot of people think that this video is proof that the legend is real. The CCTV footage comes from Manchester, England, where a supposed poltergeist temporarily turned an insurance office into its stomping grounds. The surveillance footage looks fairly normal for the first minute or so, but then things start to get strange shortly thereafter. After tossing around some chairs, the office ghost becomes much more violent and aggressive. Now the ghost flings open filing cabinets and slams doors while jiggling the doorknob to one room in particular with an angry intensity. What's inside that room is anyone's guess, but it's clear that the ghost is paying special attention to that area. It desperately wants to get in. Finally, the door to that mysterious room opens and closes, and the office settles back into an eerie silence. The ghost seems to be satisfied for now after gaining entry, and it seems to have stopped throwing a paranormal tantrum, at least for the time being. It's hard for me to tell if this video is actually real or if it is a hoax. I can probably go either way on this one. Based on the comments for this video, the internet seems to largely agree. Two girls are sharing a meal while their mother lovingly watches. It looks like a nice family moment until the girl closest to the camera notices something in the other room and lets out a frightened whimper.
What?
I'm scared.
It's okay. I just turned off the lights, that's all.
Nobody else sees it, and they continue eating. Her sister tries to cheer the worried girl up, but she sees something again and starts to cry out of fear. Her mother asks her what's wrong, and all the girl can do is point to the other room. She stands up, no longer able to be near whatever it is that she sees, and then she runs to her mom for protection. Her sister is laughing hysterically at all of this, but then she turns around and sees it for herself.
Turn around, but you gotta listen to me. Turn around, look at me. What's the matter?
The video ends shortly afterwards, but that's not all. Some YouTubers say that they can see the outline of a figure peering around the corner just moments before the video cuts out. It's supposed to appear on the right-hand side of the doorway. Let me know if you see anything. This woman claims that she would go to bed at night, only to be woken up by strange noises and left with the unshakable feeling that she was not alone. When she sets up a camera to record some evidence, she finds this bizarre footage the next day. Imagine watching yourself trying to sleep while this figure haunts your dreams. At one point, the supposed phantom appears to be lunging at her. She says that she believes she was still awake during this point and remembers seeing nothing. Only when the contrast on the video was enhanced did anything become visible. On November 21st, 2016, a giant fireball shot over Port Charlotte, Florida, and landed in an undisclosed location. This event was caught on multiple dash cams. As the footage shows, the huge streak of light hits the earth at a high rate of speed and fills a large portion of the sky with a metallic blue color. There has been no official explanation, but everything from a radiation-laced meteorite to a failed EMP has been proposed. What I find strangest of all is that no damage was reported. Look at the footage closely. Most people agree that this was a meteorite. But what do you think this was? It's Friday the 13th, and unlike most of the other videos on this list, Chris and Jeff actually believe in Bloody Mary. They are prepared to run for their lives the moment they see any trouble. Jeff stands outside of the room with a flashlight, while Chris goes inside to summon Mary by himself.
Okay.
Oh man, that's kind of creepy.
No,
come on, man. No, you gotta
close it.
Can you please be in here?
No.
Please.
No.
Chris hesitates for a long time before finally uttering her name three times. Nothing happens, that is, until he turns around to leave. That's when Jeff sees something.
I'm serious. I seen something. Did you get that on camera?
I don't know. You freaking scared the
woman in there.
Jeff says that she was tall and reaching out for him. Some YouTubers say if you slow down a portion of the video, you can see a person facing the wall with their back to the camera. Let me know if you see anything.
Get on camera.
A man in St. Louis, Missouri, suspects that he's captured a sign from above at the St. Peter and Paul graveyard. Or maybe it's a sign from down below, the twisted, gnarled tree in this video has been struck by lightning, and now it has a flaming and smoking center that looks like the gates to the underworld. Could this be a warning of an ominous future event, or just a simple act of nature? This video was uploaded by a YouTuber named The Guitar Family, and it captures a strange moment during one of CNN's news broadcasts. A typical news segment looks to be going exactly as planned, but then a very strange technical malfunction occurs. Pay close attention to the face of the man on the right.
Hi, Anderson. Well, there hasn't been any statement or anything from the Assad regime. However, they have reacted there.
I generally don't pay much attention to these types of videos because, honestly, I usually can't even tell what they're trying to point out. But in this video, something strange clearly happens with the news anchor's eyes. They look like they change into some unnatural color and then go back to normal. Some people say the fluorescent light is reflecting off of his contact lenses, but others aren't so sure. It sounds like a good explanation to me, but then again, with all of the conspiracy theories that have turned out to be true in the past, I honestly can't say for sure. In this quick clip, a group of kids are playing soccer when a strange and mysterious creature decides to crash their game. Watch closely as a black object approaches them from the right.
Don't
The poor quality of this video makes it hard to tell exactly what this creature is. It's very small and the way it shuffles side to side does not look natural at all. It's very difficult, if not impossible, to make out a face or even any limbs. It could be a wild animal, but the way that the children and even the dog all run away in absolute horror has many people convinced that this creature could be paranormal or even extraterrestrial. Even when you slow down the video and zoom in on the creature, it's hard to tell what it could be. I personally have no idea what it is, and I definitely like to read your best guess in the comments below. This footage, taken from a British oil rig, looks fairly normal until a massive monster slowly rises from the depths of the sea. Its shimmering, shapeless body is both mysterious and mesmerizing as it glides across the ocean with a silky stride. The camera person excitedly pans around to keep the beast in their sights. Unable to believe what they are witnessing, the formless monster hangs around the rig for a while before losing interest and moving on. When this video first surfaced, most people thought that it had to be part of a whale, but that theory proved incorrect. Scientists said that part of the whale was too nutritious to float around the ocean for very long and that it would be eaten almost immediately. They were eventually able to identify the creature as a giant jellyfish called the Deep Staria Reticulum. This video was recorded more than 5 years ago. It shows the pointer moving around the Ouija board on its own at first, but then it somehow levitates and begins flying away. There's a good chance that this is CGI. At least, that's the only explanation that I can think of besides actual spirits. Residents in Tallahassee, Florida, feared for their lives when this strange and haunting sound echoed throughout their area for over 20 minutes.
It's not back that way, it's up in this corner. Don't go out there.
There's little doubt that this video is real, as you can hear the fear in the family's voices.
Get the kids in the bathroom.
I hear the wind.
Get the kids in the bathroom.
Kids in the bathroom. Kids.
I thought it was a tornado, but the person in the video doesn't. They called 911 and learned that police were apparently flooded with concerned complaints about the noise. The person who recorded this footage says that the local news was told to report this as an airplane. This doesn't really sound like an airplane to me. There's one other strange occurrence, a sudden flash of lightning that instantly makes the noise disappear. I've never been in a tornado before, so I can't say if this video looks normal or not. I'm especially looking for opinions from people who have been in one. Do you agree with the uploader that this could have been something more than a tornado, like a government weather experiment? An older brother is trying to show his younger sibling that Bloody Mary is not real. Now the two of them are alone in the bathroom to test this theory out. They say her name 3 times in the dark. And when they turn the lights back on, they mistakenly think they are safe.
Open. See? What? It's all over. See, that's not gonna happen.
These books appear to be flying off the shelf all by themselves at an Alamo gift shop after hours. It's hard to tell if they were truly pulled out by a ghost, or if someone was just pushing them from the other side of the shelf and playing a prank. We'll never know for sure, but if this were to happen anywhere in Texas, then a historical site like the Alamo would be a very likely location. A YouTuber named DX5K doesn't really believe in Bloody Mary, but at the same time, he just can't seem to stop trying to summon her. This is his 3rd try, and it seems to be going as poorly as the other 2 attempts. He gets an idea and decides that he should try to summon her in total darkness, and that's when things start to get interesting in a potentially paranormal way.
Maybe without the candle. Wow, I tried to put a candle out and it came back on. Let's try it again. Wow, that's actually spooky. I can't blow the candle out. Now this is getting interesting. This is what I like. Let's go.
The candle continues to stay lit despite blowing straight on it. You can hear the curiosity in his voice as DX5K starts to consider the possibility that he may not be alone after all. He quickly shakes the thought out of his mind and tries to blow out the candles for a third time.
Nah, say something. I blew your candle out. I seen you kept trying to put the candle back up. It's lit.
This time, the candle goes out and he resumes talking trash to Bloody Mary. This could be proof that the legend is not real, or maybe Bloody Mary does not show up for non-believers. If it's not real, then I'd like to know why he couldn't blow out the candle. It doesn't really sound like he is acting. It's a dreary and overcast day when a YouTuber named Sharby straps a GoPro on his head and heads into an abandoned graveyard with his friend. This eerie graveyard is surrounded by woods and is in the middle of nowhere, as Sharby puts it, and they are hoping to find some adventure. They are checking out old headstones and goofing off when a frightening discovery suddenly changes the mood.
What? Is that a knife, dude?
It appears to be a rusty old crowbar that was perhaps used to dig up graves. Both Sharby and his friend instantly get a bad feeling, and Sharby throws it to the ground, suddenly wanting nothing to do with the ancient object. They keep exploring and eventually come across a grave from 1811. The unshakable feeling of dread just won't go away, and suddenly it begins to snow, which is very odd weather for October. Not too far away, they discovered a battered doll and get seriously freaked out by its mere presence.
Okay, yo, let's get the f*** out of here, man. No, okay, that's it.
Some branches snap in the nearby woods, and they quickly flee before they can find out what was near them. This footage was taken after hours by a staff member on a college campus in North Yorkshire. It was shot through a classroom window and shows the outline of a person attentively studying at a computer, seemingly without knowing that they were being filmed. The only problem is that no one else should have been in the building at the time. The video could be CGI, or it could be the actual weightless black mass of a real ghost. A group of girls are recording their Ouija experience in hopes of catching something interesting, but it doesn't seem to be going very well.
This is ridiculous. I'm so done.
Yeah, my arm hurts.
Guys,
there's no point. Nothing's gonna happen.
Just when they are about to give up, however, something on the other side apparently takes notice.
Oh, what do you think is that?
They begin to argue and blame each other for moving the pointer. Then they become freaked out when they realize that this is no joke. The bravest one in the group asks the spirit for its name.
I told you, Jay. I told you it wasn't me.
Oh.
John, it replies. He is 36 years old. They ask John how he lost his life. G-U-N, John spells. He also reveals that it happened in his home. One of the friends becomes certain that this is a joke, and she comes up with a plan to prove it.
So say something then.
Say boo. Boo.
Difficult ghost.
Boo.
Something crashes behind them as John sarcastically spells out B-O-O. Then, when one of the girls says he can't hurt them, he launches the pointer straight into her foot and the video ends. Tim and two of his friends are going to explore a house that is legendarily haunted. According to local lore, this is a place where devil-worshipping members used to perform rituals, and the surrounding area has never been the same since. Beyond this information, all they know is that its general location is somewhere deep in the woods. They follow a trail and eventually come across a large abandoned house in the middle of the night. The three of them all get a strange feeling and instantly know that they are in the right spot. The door is open and they bravely march inside. Beyond a room filled with strange scrawlings, they find a dark room that stinks like something rotting. Dolls are hanging by their necks. Just when they are about to leave, they suddenly are approached by something that comes up from behind.
Do you hear that?
A strange and unsettling gurgling noise follows them as they run out of the house and into the open night air. Whether this was scripted or legitimate is anyone's guess, only they know for sure, but even still, they may be too shaken to talk about it. This footage was taken in 1997, a year filled with strange sightings of a mysterious beast lurking deep in the woods of Emerson, Missouri. One day, a wildlife warden finds a camera ominously laying in the middle of a nature trail. He checks the footage and is stunned by what he finds. The footage was apparently taken by a pair of hunters. The two of them are walking through the woods when an evil-looking transparent figure suddenly approaches.
You see that? Over there, look, 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 over there. You see that?
What the hell?
Wait, that, because that was it again, right there.
The see-through creature looks small and menacing as it glides across the forest floor without so much as a sound. They lose track of the creature for a bit and then find it again. This time, the camera zooms in for a better look.
Wait.
I don't like this.
You see that? Right there. Look.
Oh my god. That's not an animal. I don't like it.
Okay, fuck. Go.
The unidentifiable creature sees them and squats down in a low and aggressive posture. It lets out an inhuman shriek that sounds both high-pitched and deep at the same time. The men run deeper into the woods, terrified out of their minds as the thing presumably tracks them like prey. What happens from there is unknown. Hopefully, they make it out of the woods alive, but in the decades since, no one has ever come forward to claim the video as their own. This footage was taken when a team of curious German explorers traveled deep into Africa to talk with a powerful shaman who claimed to have many spiritual gifts. When they asked him to demonstrate what he was capable of to their cameras and to the world at large, the shaman, whose name was Ovaku, decided to dazzle them with this maneuver. The tribe chants a mysterious song of celebration and encouragement as Ovaku hangs suspended in mid-air. This incredible act looks like it's taking a lot of physical strength as well as mental concentration to perform. The shaman is gasping for breath and appears to be struggling hard to stay afloat. When he drops to the ground, he is exhausted and looks like he is about to pass out on the spot. Determining whether this footage is real or not depends on how much you are willing to trust the German explorers. They insist that no lifts or pulleys were used, and they do seem genuinely amazed while filming, but who knows what they were really thinking for sure. I will admit that there doesn't seem to be any strings attached to them during the close-up shots, so maybe the shaman can really levitate after all. Here's another video from the mysterious Menger Hotel. A woman is bored and giving a brief tour of her room when suddenly a paranormal presence makes itself known.
Hello? Mike?
She waits for a tense moment, hoping that her boyfriend Mike is playing a prank nearby. When nobody answers her, she bravely opens the door and looks into the other room. Here's what she finds.
Nuh-uh. Oh my god.
Something has dumped all of her possessions onto the floor in a quick fit of rage. While it's possible that she could have done this herself, it's also quite possible that this really was a paranormal encounter, especially when you consider that fires, missing things, and other strange happenings have become the norm over the years at this hotel, which was also built over the famous Alamo battle site. There's a graveyard in the community of Poetry that is famous for a very strange phenomenon, flashlight controlling ghosts. Apparently, spirits will sometimes take control of flashlights in this area, apparently using them to communicate with the living and answer basic questions.
Did you come through the vortex?
Oh, wow.
Thank you.
What's really weird to me is how the light slowly fades away instead of turning straight off like normal.
So they have a destination when they...
And this isn't the only video I've found where this happens.
Are you gonna turn it off? I see it getting very dim. Are you playing with the flashlight now?
Wait. Can someone explain how this is happening? If it's not being caused by the paranormal, you can't see the bottom of the flashlight in the second video, so maybe their hand is still on it, but nobody is touching the flashlight in the first video, so that one looks especially real. And if you've ever tried this at Dry Creek Graveyard, then we would definitely like to read what happened to you next. So please let us know in the comments section. Museum maintenance workers in Manchester, England, were very surprised when this ancient Egyptian statue began moving by itself. It would always shift in its display case when they aren't looking, and when they put it back in its spot, it would just move again on its own later. After determining that this was not some kind of prank, the museum workers became extremely curious and set up a camera. They were stunned to find the 4,000-year-old statue gradually moving in a perfect circle completely by itself on camera. Scientists studied this video extensively and eventually concluded that vibrations from foot traffic and nearby buses were causing the small figurine to shift in place. However, museum workers note that this figure has been part of their collection for 80 years. And it has never moved before, so this reason is not exactly foolproof. Also, none of the other museum artifacts have ever displayed this kind of behavior, which has led many YouTubers to believe that this explanation is merely a cover-up for the paranormal truth and possibly a dangerous curse. This tape is probably one of the most morbid things I've ever seen. A deranged teen casually explains how to dig up graves and extract what's inside both as a hobby and for profit. And the amount of detail he puts into his explanations make me think that this is undoubtedly real. You'll have to watch the video for yourself to get all of the sickening facts, but basically he says that he digs them up and sells them to local magic shops for a profit. He then goes on to explain how to detach the top from the body and how to do things like convert it into a candle holder to make more money. He says that he can tell how old it is by the color, and he even talks about how to remove the brain. He says all of this while supposedly handling one that he took as an example. The more he talks, the more I hope that he is just holding a prop and making all of this up. During this part of the video, however, you can see a hole where it fits into the spinal cord, which makes me think that he is not lying after all.
Okay, pull it back like that. It should loosen up from the spinal cords, that way you don't mess up this part and everything, ripping it off, okay? Pull it back, okay?
You'll also notice around the 5.5 minute mark of the video that he has deep marks on his hands. It looks to me as if he really has been digging up what he says he is. There's little doubt in my mind that this video was really taken in the 90s. You can even see a copy of Evil Dead 2 next to him, and the VHS box looks new. So the question is this video real, or was this just a group of friends who were just joking around? Well, one part of this video in particular makes me think that he is being absolutely serious.
Make sure there's no witnesses when you leave, always bring it back. If you leave witnesses, sometimes you might like doing these things and everything at the wall. Somebody might see them and say, that was him. That was him. That was him. Never let anybody point you out.
He has never been caught or even identified. Avery is almost 2 years old. He's happily babbling away in the kitchen when his mother starts to feel a strange presence. This has happened a few times before, so she decides to start recording. Normally, her child is very quiet, but every once in a while, he will become very active and start having a conversation with someone who neither of his parents could see.
Who are you talking to?
Avery's mother finds this behavior very perplexing, so she starts to ask him over and over who he is talking to. Finally, after the third or fourth time, she gets a sinister reply.
Who are you talking to?
Her child looks over his shoulder, almost as if someone is there. When he turns his back to her, a raspy voice says, Ryan. Listen again with the sound up if you don't hear it. I guess this voice could be coming from Avery, but it sounds like it's coming from someplace much closer, almost right next to the camera. It almost sounds like a slightly different voice than Avery's. Maybe Ryan is a ghostly pal who is looking to make a new friend. A YouTuber named Leviathan is on a hiking trip when he hears strange noises in the distance. Just when he seriously suspects that he's not alone in the woods, a series of large footprints confirms his suspicions. He now fears for his safety and has already decided to leave when he hears the same noises again, much closer now than before. The predatory call encourages him to make a quick retreat back to civilization. Leviathan still has no idea what was making this noise or exactly how large it was. Two friends think they may have recorded the presence of a spirit when they entered a graveyard late at night. Here's their evidence. Look at the back row of tombstones on the right and focus on the one that's closest to the road.
I only see what's in front of us.
We'll turn my show off.
An intense source of light plays over the gravestone. It could be a reflection of their headlights bouncing off some glass, but something seems a little off about the angle. And if this gravestone was not made of glass, then there is absolutely no explanation for this video. Let me know if you think this is real, or if they got fooled by their own car.
I only see what's in front.
Julie Copper is the owner of the Dawn War Memorial Bar in Stockton, London. She gets many visitors every year, but there is one ghostly patron in particular that she will never forget. She even has video evidence to back up her mysterious story. One night, a bar band was practicing in the upstairs area. They take a short break and all of the lights suddenly go out. Moments before the power surge, you can see something strange dart across the three of the CCTV monitors. It's a shadowy black figure that Julie claims to have seen plenty of times before, and it's not the only paranormal encounter that she's witnessed while working at the bar. The upstairs of the bar has a very pleasant feeling according to her, but it's the downstairs that feels somewhat off and evil. Julie refuses to go down there by herself ever since she heard someone playing a game of pool and thought it was the maintenance. When she called out his name, however, she found no one was there. This footage comes from a hotel camera in New York that's near Niagara Falls. Shane Sovar is a hotel manager who claims to have seen a large triangular UFO shoot pass by his window one night. An on-duty hotel security officer backs up this claim and says that he saw it too. They contact an amateur UFO group called the Aerial Phenomenon Investigation team, who does a standard investigation and leaves. Things get very odd soon after. Around 2 weeks after the aerial phenomenon was finished their investigation, a pair of men dressed in all black suits reportedly entered the hotel and began to interrogate witnesses for more information. They specifically wanted to know where Shane and the hotel security guard could be found. Shane said that people who had spoken with the men later told him how strange they looked. They were tall, pale, had no eyebrows or eyelashes, and basically looked exactly the same. They had especially large and unsettling eyes, and one woman told Shane that she felt like they were able to read her mind. Whether these two men were simply businessmen on vacation or actual government agents is anyone's guess, but Shane swears that he is telling the truth, exactly what the team of UFO investigators had found during their investigation, along with whatever these men were looking for, has never been released to the public. This apparent apparition wastes no time completely demolishing the kitchen of a YouTuber named Chris Well. It starts at the far end of the room and makes its way forward. Things quiet down for a moment, and then the mayhem resumes, this time, even closer to the camera. I will admit this video looks very realistic. I can't see any strings, and some of the things that happen, like the flying chairs at the end, would be very hard to fake. Besides, I don't know why someone would go to the effort of trashing their own house just to make a YouTube video. It hardly seems worth it. Chris Well claims he has no idea what happened that night. He is very upset and even went so far as to personally demand answers directly from the poltergeist itself, but of course to no avail. According to a team of ghost hunters, this house in San Pedro, California has long been haunted by poltergeists who like to open cupboards, throw plates, change television channels, and linger in certain rooms until a mother and her two children felt uncomfortable enough to leave. A lot of events happened before the ghost hunters became involved and therefore were never recorded, but it wasn't uncommon for red liquid to drip from the walls of this haunted home for no explainable reason. Here is a quick clip of this happening in real time before the team's very eyes.
Everyone just left except us. Things are starting to drip out of the cabinets. Nobody believes, but it's happening.
There it is.
There it is, right there.
It's dripping.
Eventually, the ghosts drive the mother and her children out of the home, and the ghost hunters volunteer to stay there and investigate for several months. One day, they hear three loud snapping noises coming from the attic and send a man named Barry to investigate. As he later recalls, something was up there waiting for them.
Are you okay, buddy?
God.
Look at his neck. Look,
him up.
What's behind your neck?
I don't know. What's on my neck?
Come on down. Barry, get down.
Barry comes back down distraught and confused, now missing his glasses. Some kind of cord is wrapped around his neck, and he insists that something had tried to choke him upstairs in the attic. The investigation was called off not long after, out of a concern for the team's personal safety. Two friends look out the window and see a mysterious figure dressed in all white, roaming the graveyard without shoes. She has her head down and pays absolutely no attention to them, even as they call out to her.
Hey! What you doing, girl?
Yo, that is creepy as...
What the f***?
What happened?
What the f*** is she doing?
Why is she touching other people's graves?
Finally, she starts to walk towards them, and they quiet down. One of the friends quickly points out that now she knows where they live. He screams out the window that she's scaring him, and she walks away, still completely lost in her own world. Here's where things get even more weird. She heads to the back of the graveyard, spins around a few times, and then disappears behind a tall gravestone.
I'm holding this camera until she come out from behind that tombstone.
Yo, she's not coming back.
She's gone. Where the f*** did she go? We watched her walk behind a tombstone and she's gone.
They think that she has vanished, but I think she could have just been sitting down on the other side. The two friends say that they kept filming for a long time, and never saw her again, so maybe she really did disappear. Still, it's hard to tell if this was a genuine spirit or just someone with a morbid attraction to graveyards. That's what this YouTuber thinks about Bloody Mary after making this video. He says her name way more than 3 times, and then begins to taunt her out loud.
Are you real Bloody Mary? Or are you just a f***ing joke? Did y'all just hear that?
Still not convinced, the brave teen says her name some more and waits. It isn't long before he gets his reply.
Do that. What's going on here?
Drawers are opening on their own, the faucet turns on, and he soon concludes that Bloody Mary is very real after all. He goes to grab the door and finds that it won't budge. He puts his hands on top of his head now, obviously distressed, just when he is sure that he's a goner. He manages to open the door and make an escape. This footage was reportedly taken on a flight somewhere over Zambia. A person is casually recording out their window when a giant humanoid creature starts to materialize in the distance. The creature seems to keep pace and ride alongside them for a moment before disengaging and twisting away. The obvious answer to this is CGI. If it's not CGI, however, then what this creature could be is anyone's guess. In 2009, a strange phenomenon rocked the residents of Norway just before sunrise. Many Norwegians were surprised to find a glowing beam of light just beyond the white-capped mountain ranges. Suddenly, the beam exploded into a huge hypnotizing spiral of white light that was hundreds of miles long. No one quite understood what they were watching as they all vacantly stared into the bright white vortex, totally mesmerized. Then, without a sound, the vortex shifted into a black hole and disappeared as quickly as it came. To this day, no real plausible explanation exists for why a huge vortex opened up over Norway. It was so big that people saw it as far away as Sweden. Some people even insist that it was a government weather experiment or else a real-life portal that probably went to some place you'd never want to visit. A man is walking around the infamous Alcatraz when he picks up 2 possible paranormal encounters. I'll start with the weirdest one first. He is inspecting a roll of holding cells when a loud voice seems to call out to him with a single question. It sounds to me as if the deep voice is asking one simple word, why? The second possible encounter occurs as he is entering another part of the prison. Listen to this strange and haunting laugh. This one has a fairly reasonable explanation. Alcatraz is on an island, so maybe this was a bird call echoing off the prison's walls. I can't tell for sure, so let me know what you think about these 2 events. This tunnel in Blue Ash, Ohio, is steeped in local lore, and none of it is good. Apparently, a cult once used this maze of sewer passages to hold all sorts of rituals and sacrifices. This makes a YouTuber named The Fam want to explore the area with his friends, though now I'm sure he wishes he hadn't. Everything starts out fine at first, but soon The Fam claims to feel more and more sick as he draws closer to the infamous altar room, which is where most of the sacrifices were supposedly made. Something makes him have a panic attack, and he claims to have felt ill for a long time after making this video. It's impossible to tell if he really is being affected by spirits, or if he simply contracts a sickness from being in the sewer, or if it's his nerves getting the better of him. I'll let you decide for yourself. Here's a clip of him at the beginning of the video.
Alright guys, I'm gonna keep on going. I gotta see if we can find this altar room. Not looking forward to finding it, really.
Feeling normal. And here's his reaction after discovering the sacrificial altar room.
I'm having a panic attack.
You're having a panic attack?
I did a couple minutes ago.
Do you think he really is getting sick from being in the presence of pure evil? This video comes from a YouTuber named Kusun2. He's a college student with an original Xbox that has a very strange and unexplainable problem. Every time he is hanging out by himself, his console likes to turn itself on. This happens so often that Kusun2 decides to record it for evidence. The only problem is that this Xbox appears to be camera shy. He'll stare and stare at it and it won't do a thing. It only seems to turn on when he is doing something else, almost as if it's trying to distract him. Even now as he films his Xbox and explains his story, it refuses to turn on by itself and makes him look like a fool. After talking for about 5 minutes, Kusun2 finally decides to test his theory and leaves the room. The Xbox does nothing for a long time, but then... Keep in mind that there's no way to turn on an original Xbox remotely, and he always keeps his controller neatly wrapped up on the top of the system, so he can't be using a controller that's out of sight. On top of that, things have been regularly disappearing and reappearing on their own. And now Kusun2 is extremely creeped out about being alone. A man claims that he keeps experiencing paranormal activity in his dining room and nowhere else. He feels unsafe and decides to leave a camera running in the dining room to see what goes on when he's not around. Nothing happens for a while, but then something comes along in the window that looks questionable. This is the zoomed in version. A tiny face appears to peek out at them from the glass panel on the bottom right before darting out of sight. You can't really make out any of its features, but notice how some orbs float by shortly before this happens. It's hard to tell if it's a paranormal creature or just a small animal, but I wouldn't want to be left alone in the house to find out. Three friends bravely choose to summon Bloody Mary while one of their parents records. They recite her name 3 times in the mirror, and when nothing happens, they decide that the legend is a bust. The dad makes fun of them for a little bit, and they go on with their day.
I guess now we know that Mary Worth doesn't like you.
According to them, it wasn't until much later that they actually looked at the video and noticed some strange occurrences that made them upload it onto YouTube. Look at the countertop in the upper left-hand corner.
Oh, please, come on now. What other ideas?
I don't know, other ideas of how to get her to jump out of the mirror at us.
Maybe it takes a little longer.
Like how long?
I don't know. I don't know, like a couple minutes.
The candle appears to move by itself on at least 2 separate occasions. I guess it could have been magnets, but I really don't understand how. It's important to add that they were all picking the candles up to light them just a moment earlier, and nothing was hidden underneath. Give me your best guess as to how they move these candles. Or better yet, tell me if you think it was Bloody Mary who was moving them. Construction workers in Brazil were performing a demolition job when they came across the flattened remains of a 33-foot anaconda. If you want to get a better feel for how gigantic this snake is, just count how many seconds it takes them to film the reptile's entire body. Not much more information about this story is available, but then again, not much more information is required. This is a gigantic snake that, given the opportunity, would have little problem squeezing your ribs until they cracked and making you its next meal. This footage comes from India, where a woman is seen cleaning up at a sink. Suddenly, a dark figure appears behind her and gives her a hard shove from behind. She turns around only to find the room empty and hurries away. This dashcam footage was taken from the Garland City Police Department. A police officer is chasing a car at high speeds when things suddenly go off-road. The car has turned into a dead end and is coming up on a chain-link fence. It looks like the chase is over, but then this happens.
The fence at the end means no way out, or does it?
The car appears to have escaped through a solid chain link fence with no gate or any other type of opening to pass through. Every officer who has reviewed this footage has been completely baffled, and no explanation has ever been given. You can tell by the angle of the car's brake lights that it was driving straight the whole time and did not swerve around the fence. Somehow, there's no signs of damage to the fence. It looks completely untouched. A group of British ghost hunters are walking around the Wilney graveyard in search of paranormal evidence. It's late at night when they apparently find exactly what they are looking for. Pay close attention to the area between the two tombstones or you might miss it.
What the f- was that?
The man's flashlight passes over a tall silhouette that makes him pause. It looks like it could have simply been some shadows playing against the wall, but they light up the entire area, and there's no wall to be found. Let me know if you saw the strange shadowy figure and what you think it could have been. A YouTuber named Nugget Noggin is exploring an old abandoned home one evening somewhere in the deep south. He's been here only once before, and it gave him such a strange and foreboding feeling that he couldn't take it anymore and he had to leave. Now he's mustered up enough courage to come back and check out the rest of the house. He wants to get up to the second floor.
All right, I got this little door here to keep the air from rising up. All right, I don't know. Could be somebody up there. Oh man, somebody's standing on it. I sure can't lift it up.
Much to his dismay, he finds a door has been laid over the top of the stairway so that nobody can get through. He tries to push on the horizontal door. One moment, it feels as if a heavy force is standing on top of it, and the next moment, the weight is suddenly gone, and Nugget Noggin can get upstairs. Some rooms give him the same weird feeling that made him flee before. He remembers that the front door was kicked in. Possibly someone broke in. Maybe a family was living here long ago and things did not end well for them.
Won't be able to sleep. Look, there's a light on in there. It's odd. There's a mirror. You know what time it is?
Nugget Noggin doesn't find much else and leaves. When he's reviewing the footage, however, he does notice what could be the face of a small girl. Take a look at this picture and tell me if it looks like anything paranormal to you. After multiple nights of getting no sleep and experiencing a deep sense of dread, this person sets up multiple cameras to record exactly what happens to them at night. When they check out the cameras the next day, they find this strange encounter. A faint shadow appears to linger above them for a moment before fading away. It has an unnatural shape and almost seems to reach out at them. This video could be fake because this person was sleeping with their lights on, which is strange. But then again, maybe they were just trying to make sure there was plenty of light to catch the ghost on video. Some people have even suggested that this person was having an out-of-body experience during REM sleep. The Driscoll Hotel is one of the most legendarily haunted hotels in all of Texas. This is where you'll find a painting of a senator's 4-year-old daughter named Samantha, who supposedly fell down a flight of steps at the hotel and met her end. Her soul is said to reside in the painting now, and she will change facial expressions if you look at her for long enough. Just look at what happens when this YouTuber named Emily takes a glance at the painting.
Oh, her face does change.
Has it changed?
Yes, it just changed when I started looking at it.
Jacob, did it change?
After freaking out for a bit, Emily bravely walks back up to the picture and takes another look. Try to examine the picture when the camera zooms in on it and tell me if you see Samantha's eyes move. I personally do not see it, but maybe I'm missing something.
Her eyes are moving. Oh my god. Her eyes just moved up. I'm not lying.
If you want to find out what else this painting can supposedly do, then be sure to check out my other video called 7 Haunted Paintings. What you are watching is not a fireworks show, but rather a rare and mysterious natural phenomenon known as Naga fireballs. These strange fireballs literally shoot up from the water every year and can be tiny as sparks or large as a basketball. You can see them from Thailand and Laos. Scientists have no idea what causes these fireballs, but some locals believe that this is a display of power from a serpent-like bodyguard who once watched over Buddha. A man is filming his local graveyard one calm day when he catches what could be a glimpse of the other side. He zooms in on the strange spot and finds no further traces of the paranormal. I don't know about you, but I can almost make out the head and shoulders of a small child when he slows the video down. The Menger Hotel in San Antonio, Texas, claims to be one of the most haunted areas in the entire state, and there are plenty of videos to back up this statement. One of these videos involves a brother and sister who both suddenly get a strange feeling from the building and decide to start recording. They are exploring a very small and cramped area of the hotel. As they are discussing the possibilities out loud, the woman suddenly announces that she is extremely uncomfortable. You can't see it very well at first, but soon the camera zooms in and reveals three deep scratches along the woman's bare shoulder. They look fresh and sting badly. She says that she was simply sitting on the steps for just one moment, and the jagged marks appeared as soon as she stood up. Judging from this video, it looks as though she may have been literally cut by an angry ghost. This CCTV footage shows a young woman hurrying down a flight of steps, only to find something waiting for her at the bottom of the stairwell. The shadowy figure turns towards her, and if you look closely, you can almost make out the circular white outline of a face. She bolts away and the apparition quickly pursues. If this video is real, then nobody knows what happened next, or if she even survived. Recent footage from China apparently shows two identical suns orbiting next to each other. This footage has been credited as authentic, and even the world's top scientists have been unable to agree on an official explanation. This only lasted for a short while before the sun apparently went back to normal. One scientist suggests that it could have been an optical illusion caused by light reflecting off a thick path of atmosphere. I think this is a reasonable explanation since, if there were suddenly two suns, then the increase in temperature probably would have fried us all. Unless, of course, there have always been two suns all along. According to the legend, there are many different ways to summon Bloody Mary, which means that the method you choose could change what happens to you. The person in this video uses a slightly different method that I've never seen before. Instead of spinning around three times and then saying Bloody Mary, she says Bloody Mary once after each spin. This is the end result. Her face becomes smeared and she quickly darts out of the room. If this video is real, then it appears that Bloody Mary somehow removed all of her facial features, perhaps as a warning. A YouTuber named Trey P is wandering around an empty graveyard somewhere in New Orleans all by himself when he hears this voice out of nowhere. He claims that the voice belongs to a ghost, though to be honest, it might just be his. The only way to tell if this video is real would be to have Trey P say a sentence and then compare his voice with the voice in the video. This alleged ghost was caught on video, rummaging around a property of an arcade in Dallas. The phantom blob glides over the grass and quickly fits through an entranceway. It's pretty convincing to me. Here's a second video of it. This looks like a cheaper camera, but it picks up the same shape. The only possible explanation I have besides the paranormal is maybe an insect is crawling across the lens. You may be wondering what something called a kissing bug is doing at number one until you realize that this is what its version of a kiss is. These bugs are known for doing the same thing as mosquitoes, but on people's faces at night, especially on their lips, hence their name. As this bug helps itself to your face, it is also potentially spreading a nasty ailment called Chagas. The CDC recently released a report that says you have a 30% chance of getting Chagas in your lifetime. If this happens, you could feel fine for months before displaying any ill effects. And even then, these effects might be mild at first. You could feel fatigued and feverish, and you might think you have a bad flu, when really the bug's ailment is just working its way deeper into your body. It can lay dormant in your system for decades before striking. It can make your heart increase in size so badly that it doesn't beat properly anymore. Or your entire digestive system could grow so large that you can't even stand to eat or use the facilities anymore from the horrible cramps all throughout your body. This ailment can take your life if it is not detected early enough, and even if it is detected, it might still be too late to completely get rid of it. You can only control it with things that are so powerful that only the CDC is allowed to administer them, and even these come with alarming side effects that nobody would want to have. And to think, all of this can come from a simple bug bite in the state of Texas. Thank you so much for getting me to 2,000 subscribers on my Clips channel. If you want to support, please press that subscribe button. Let's get to 5,000 subscribers. Thank you.